Welcome back. Well, the SGX Nifty is now up 16 points. Let's see how things move. Today's expiry, of course, has been a rank bad series. We are at the lowest point of the series, almost lowest point of the series. Ashwani Gujral, Sudarshan Sukhani, and Mitesh Thakkar now join us. Good morning. Ashwani, what's the call on the index today?
Well, good morning. And yesterday was a bit of a trend day. So my sense is that today being expiry, etc., you could be sideways. So broadly, you know, yesterday's range should hold on. Now, yesterday's range was fairly wide. The range may also narrow. So you can say, 11,250, 260, to about 11,300, 320. But overall, I expect choppiness. And try to do things at boundaries and in the other direction. So that sort of strategy is much more likely to work. Today, selling gap up, etc., may not work because we had our bit of trend day yesterday, and Bank Nifty still managed to close at the lows of the day. So again, Bank Nifty could be in a bit of a range, 28,800 to about 29,200. So have modest expectations today on the index.
Okay, thank you very much, Ashwini. Sudarshan, good morning to you. Hope you're keeping well. How would you look at the indices? 11,300 has been breached. And Nifty Bank also, as Ashwini pointed out, at yesterday ending at lows. But for me, the important point was the HDFC twins, after a lot of red, saw green yesterday. Is that significant?
Yeah, good morning. I'm fine now. Thanks a lot. See, the Nifty has already fallen and the Nifty Bank has fallen even more. Now, both of them have come to significant support levels. We are having a range of 11,100 to 11,300 as a very strong support for the Nifty. Just remember that this is the place from where we bounced back in May, early May, and then had that election rally. So this is a support that is so far holding. You know, we have come down to 11,300 3 days ago and we are chopping around. Now, naturally, support doesn't actually yield to immediate rallies. That won't happen. But if we stay on at current levels, the chances are that we will begin a process of consolidation or accumulation. And the Nifty Bank is almost reaching its the pre-election support levels at 28,500, 28,600. So my view is that in this market now, we should expect this support to slowly develop and hold. And the trade is to be a buyer only on dips. Every dip is a buying opportunity. Some of these will not work out and some of them will give spectacular gains. So be a buyer now, expect this support to strengthen and hold on. And every time you see a dip, buy. For today, I think the values that we are likely to see in the morning is a dip. It's just below 11,300. So it's a buy with a stop at 11,240.
Okay, well, Mitesh Thakkar also joins in, so let's get a comment from him as well. Mitesh, hi, good morning. It's been relentless selling up until now. What level do you think this market could find support at in the near term, and what should the strategy be for today?
Good morning. So, we've been for many days over the last week, we've been talking about targets of 11,280 and 11,150. We have already met 11,280. And also, I think now for the first time in this entire decline, the indicator position is quite close to oversold level. So I think now is the time when you would want to be slightly more aggressive in pushing your stop losses near the current price, or possibly even taking some profits off the table. I expect that around this 11,250, 280 zone, you might see some choppiness, throwback, but getting past 11,400 would be tough. The way I'll approach the market is that if we cross 11,300, 320, then I think we'll have a stronger pullback and go to 11,400, but that should be it. So the idea is that for the time being, take some profits off, wait for the pullback to play out, and then try to sell closer to about 11,400.
Hey, let's talk about individual stocks then. Sudarshan, good morning. What's on your list?
Good morning. Well, a little more of the buying than selling. So start with Dabur. I actually also had Bata, but apparently we are sharing Bata, so I'm going with Dabur. But Bata is a buy. Right. Yeah. Dabur is a buying opportunity. The stock has already gone through a correction. It's outperforming. Actually, FMCG should now outperform. So Dabur is a buy, and so is Hindlever. Same group, same sector. Both have similar charts, except that Hindlever had a sharper dip. That dip is finding support. The third buy is Voltas. Look at good quality mid-caps and large-caps, and there is going to be a theme that they are now at low levels, they are now finding support, as the HDFC twins did yesterday, and they should be bought into. Two short sells only intraday, Hindalco and MCX. MCX is suggesting that a strong resistance is now in the offing, and Hindalco had a bad day yesterday. It's a very poor stock anyway.
Okay. Mitesh, what about you? You have a buy on Z, but that's all I see in terms of buys. Okay, there's L&T as well. So two buys and two sells today.
So slightly aggressive call on L&T. I think the stock has not yet reversed, but very oversold, very close to important medium-term support level. So chances of a bounce back are quite high. I would take this with a stop at 1370 for targets of 1415, 1420. Similarly, Z was a breakout, was a call earlier as well. Now can be bought afresh with a stop at 373 for targets of 391 and two sell calls. Steel Authority, that's a sell with a stop at 45 for targets of 40. And Century Textile, it's broken important pivot level, so take a tight stop of 906 and take short positions for targets of 865.
Okay. Ashwini, you also are going with buys for FMCGs.
Well, basically, the market has given you a theme that, you know, anything that's defensive will at least hold up in the market. And any sort of leaders of yesterday, which is autos, financials, they will continue to be under the hammer. So that way, if, you know, a pullback rally has to be engineered, it has to be on the back of, you know, very basic consumption and, you know, like we saw in the results yesterday. So people have now found some sort of, you know, place to hide. So that way, Bata is a buy with a stop of 1290, target of 1340. Wherever results are not there, even there, you know, people are trying to get into the FMCG group. Pidilite, that's a buy with a stop of 1200, target of 1265. JSPL is a sell with a stop of 140, target of 128. Piramal Enterprise is a sell with a stop of 1780, target of 1725. L&T Finance is a sell with a stop of 106, target of 94.
All right, gentlemen, thanks a lot for those technical ideas. We'll come back to you as soon as we get closer to market opening. But let's discuss the auto sector now, because yesterday there was some news flow indicating that dealers have now, you know, HDFC Bank rather has stopped inventory funding for a lot of Royal Enfield dealers. So this is what dealer checks are indicating, that funding has completely dried up, especially for some of the products like Royal Enfield. Nikunj Sanghi, the chairman of the Automotive Skill Development Council, and Ashish Kale, the president of the Federation of Automobile Dealer Association, joins us now. Gentlemen, thank you for taking the time out this morning and speaking with CNBC-TV18. Ashish, I want to start with you. Is it true that are you hearing from dealers that HDFC Bank has indeed stopped inventory funding? And is it only for dealers to Royal Enfield, or are dealers to other bikes or other products as well also experiencing this funding crunch?
Morning. So, we have discussed with dealers, and we've discussed with HDFC Bank also. But this is a routine exercise, evaluation exercise, which is going on. And this happens with all the OEMs, not particularly Royal Enfield. As we've been mentioning that, with the tight liquidity situation and the high inventory level, dealer working capital is definitely coming at a premium. But I wouldn't say that there is panic to be talked of. This is an ongoing assessment which a banker does with his customers. And I can tell you that 90-95% of the dealers have a very healthy relationship with their banker and financier.
Okay, Nikunj Sanghi, if you could come in on that. Is this a specific one bank, one product issue because they have overexposure or whatever? There are other banks and the same bank willing to, give credit to other dealers?
I don't think so. I think most banks are being a little cautious because of the slowdown in the auto sales. And they definitely do not want overexposure in terms of inventory.
Mm.
And I think it is applying to almost most banks and most brands. So I don't even think it is Royal Enfield specific.
Okay, so Mr. Sanghi, if you could say, you know, is it a stoppage of funding entirely because everybody is full with inventory? A little more color. How drastic, or do you think that things look like they are easing out, troughing out?
So I guess the stress is more in the two-wheeler space and in the CV space, okay, where the inventory levels are definitely higher than expected.
Mm-hmm.
It's not so bad in passenger vehicle segment, where manufacturers did do some amount of inventory correction.
Mm.
And going forward, we are only hoping that both two-wheelers and commercial vehicles would also probably bring down inventories. And this could probably be the best time, because this quarter is a slow quarter.
Okay.
So it's interesting, we're getting two opposing views here. Mr. Sanghi saying that, you know, funding has stopped, and not just for Royal Enfield but for other products as well. And Mr. Kale saying that there's no panic situation at the moment. Mr. Kale, I want to understand from your end, there's some talk that even if collateral is being offered now, you know, in funding has completely stopped. What is the situation on the ground, and when do you see things improving as far as dealer financing is concerned?
Say my comment was that there is no panic situation, but working capital is coming at a premium.
Okay.
There is a slowdown, and bankers are assessing, as Nikunj Sanghi just said, that high inventory is the biggest worry that bankers and financiers today have as far as auto dealership operations and their funding goes, especially in the two-wheeler and commercial vehicle space. But the comment that dealer inventory funding has stopped is incorrect. That kind of situation is not there.
Mm-hmm.
Yes, the evaluation of a dealer portfolio and his inventory funding and other limits is happening as a continuous basis. And in a slowdown, obviously, the conditions grow in terms of what a dealer should bring on the table. But I think this is an ongoing process. I don't think it is only to do with Royal Enfield or HDFC Bank. It's a continuous process, and yes, it is becoming tougher for dealers to get working capital, and therefore our association has highlighted in a very serious way the inventory situation, because dealer funding is becoming tougher for dealers to get to buy stocks. Therefore, two-wheeler inventory and commercial inventory has to come down.
Yeah, that's the point I was wanting to know. Mr.
Yeah.
Sanghi, you must have seen these seasons before. Is it at a month or two of capacity shutdowns by the OEMs will lead to this getting absorbed, and then come festival season you will restart it? How would you compare this slowdown to previous seasons that you have seen?
So this is definitely something more than the previous slowdowns, because I don't think the industry has experienced this kind of a slowdown in the first quarter of the financial year. And then this year also has challenges like the BS6 coming in, and therefore there is a lot of confusion with the dealers in terms of what they should stock. Should they be stocking BS4 as a prelude to pre-buying of BS6, or they should be cautious and be sure that they are not left with BS4 stocks when they go out of circulation on the 1st of April. So there is some skepticism, there is some amount of confusion, and then this slowdown is definitely a little bigger slowdown than has happened in the previous years.
There will be pre-buying ahead of BS6. I mean, the narrative now is that even BS6 pre-buying is going to be very muted. Festive sales is going to be muted this time around. What's your own sense, Mr. Sanghi?
So my own sense is that there will be pre-buying specifically in commercial vehicles, because there the cost impact is huge, and fleet owners and transport operators would want to have a fresh renewed fleet before BS6 sets in. So my personal opinion, and I'm keeping my fingers crossed, that at least in commercial vehicles there will be some amount of pre-buying, and the current woes of commercial vehicles would be tempered down at least for this reason. I'm not so sure about two-wheelers and the passenger car space.
Okay, just one final question, Mr. Kale. In terms of dealerships, I mean, there are a lot of reports flying around as to how many dealerships have shut in the last 6 months, 100 dealerships, etc., etc. Do we have any confirmed numbers, and what is the situation right now? I mean, in terms of dealers shutting down their dealerships?
So we had compiled the data as an association for 20 months in the month of April, so the 20 months preceding that. And there were about 209 dealerships overall, mainly in the passenger vehicle space and mainly in the metro region, which had exited. This is a number higher than usual. And this seems to be a phenomenon basically on profitability, the overall viability of the business, specifically to larger cities. And to the passenger vehicle segment.
Okay, all right. 209 dealerships, mainly in the passenger vehicle space, have exited. Thanks a lot. That's very important information. Mr. Kale and Mr. Sanghi, thanks so much for joining us. So, yes, the situation is quite grim as far as dealer financing is concerned. And up until the month of April, in the last 1 year, 209 dealerships have exited because of a whole host of issues. We'll take a quick break on that note. Still ahead.